tell me what the honoree's name is?
No.
Pasta? Christopher Roberts? Alonzo? Ah! Say it again.
Apostle? Christopher Alonzo Hilo Roberts.
All right. She almost right.
She almost right.
She promoted him to apostle. But I know for a fact that he is the Pope. Ah, yeah. He is the Pope. Hello, somebody. And now, why do we call him the Pope? Anybody can tell me why we call him the Pope?
Because of his grace.
Uh-huh. I like that. Because of his dress, his attire. Uh-huh. What else? You need to see a Micah. All right. The Pope. He is called the Pope because he is not a bishop. There are too many bishops around, but there's only one Pope. So he is the Pope. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome to the floor our first hostie. He is the music producer of all of the music that the Pope makes. He is the one that makes the Pope sound good. Everybody think the Pope could sing, but it's only because of this man behind him. Junior Scott.
All right. Good night, everybody. How y'all feeling tonight? Y'all feeling good? Oh my God. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's so good to see everyone. We're here to celebrate. Chris, can you put your hands together for Chris? Come on, give him a round of applause. All right, so I'm really happy I'm the first one to start this off. I promise you guys, I have to be honest, I'm not a professional roaster. So tonight, I'm going to be short and to the point, just like the night Chris lost his virginity. I was told by Lucas. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is a one in a lifetime opportunity to roast my brother and friend. Chris is now celebrating his 75th birthday. Can you put your hands together for Chris celebrating his 75th birthday? The question is, guys, what could I say about the Pope, Christopher Hubert Minnis Roberts? What could I say about him? He is the husband of one wife, and he has 4 kids, 3 daughters and 2 boys. It will be so obvious tonight to prank and to have fat jokes at Chris. But that would not hurt Chris' feelings tonight. Fat jokes won't. He has to look at himself every day. Cool. So guys, the easiest way to hurt Chris's feelings is to put a plate of vegetables in front of him.
Well, mother said dread.
Especially broccoli. Of course, guys, can you see? Chris obviously skips his vegetables every day. Chris believes vegetables is rabbit food. So guys, I promise, no fat jokes from me tonight. That would be really unfair. As a matter of fact, that would be bullying. Of course, you know, Chris is a Facebook bully. Of course, what could you say about a man who is 75 with a dog? Chris is a Bahamian living like an Italian mafia. The only person on Facebook Chris is afraid of is Apostle Blinkers. I'm sure Chris does not want to lose his teeth or get beaten by the staff of Moses, so Chris stay away from her. Talk about Facebook. Guys, I'm honestly scared for my life tonight. Hence, I've applied for my Canadian citizenship like most Bahamians are today, and I fly out first thing tomorrow. Guys, the truth is, if I know Chris is gonna come back at me tomorrow. If he don't come at me tomorrow, by next week he gonna post something and I realize he was talking about me. So again, guys, I promise, no fat jokes. I only have one advice, Chris. Just skip a meal every now and then. And watch the Lord trim you down like the man you wanted to be, Perry Gladstone Christian. Guys, all right. So of course I'm a music producer. I was fortunate to work with Chris. Guys, Chris is an amazing singer. Guys, Chris is an amazing singer. Put your hands together for Chris. Chris has the voice of an archangel. His voice is like a trumpet on Bay Street that needs tuning. I don't know if Chris is a valley or a Saxon. You be the judge of that. All I can say is Jesus coming soon. Chris' musical journey started when he became the choir director for the Girls Industrial School in 1935. After 71 years of faithful music ministry directing choir, Chris is now the multi-award-winning recording artist, and he has won awards all over the globe. Can you put your hands together for that accomplishment? The truth is, Chris would not have won any award without me. That's the truth. The truth is, guys, I've had to work so much on Chris' vocals. Only the guys working at Clifton Pier in the summer had to work harder than me to fix Chris's voice. I would choose load shedding any day than try to fix Chris' voice. That's when I discovered that prayer is really the key. Guys, I've never had to pray that much in my life working with Chris. But truly, I must say, I want to celebrate your accomplishments, Chris. I've seen you work hard, and God has elevated you to heights. But I have one concern, Chris. I must admit, I was a little concerned about your sexual preferences. After all, we are living in the last days, guys. Choir directors and pastors are going in and out of the closet. They are praying and interceding like never before. But guys, all my worries was laid to rest when Chris told me he had a new companion. Her name was Shekinah Glory. I was so excited to finally meet the person who captured Chris's heart. And upon meeting Shekinah, I came to the following conclusion. I realized Chris was a better man than me. Chris, you're in a better position than me. Because I realized Chris will never have to worry about having to buy Stay Free Maxi Priest tampons. Never have to worry about menstrual cycle, men on pause, moodiness, and being told not tonight, Chris, or go wash the dishes, or take out the garbage, or who is that calling you at 2 a.m. in the morning? Is that your favorite apostle? Chris, mom said to tell you, she wants grandkids. I can't wait to see those puppies. I just have one request, Chris. I would like to stand as godparent. Me and JD. And the last request is, I want the pastor to officiate the ceremony to be one, His Grace Bishop.
Dr. Neil.
Guys, I found out later that Chris had a church called Mercy Seat. And of course, after not being able to pay his BPL bills, the only seat he's sitting on is his toilet seat in his house. I believe that's where the song Mercy Said No came from. Chris is now a proud pastor of Bedside Missionary Baptist with his first lady Shekinah Glory right by his side, serving paw in hand in ministry. Guys, if you ever want to hear a dog bark in the realm of the spirit, you could pass by Chris' house every Sunday at 11 o'clock. Guys, my only worry for Chris is that one day Shekinah would leave him for a more prophetic, compatible companion Like Roof Roof. But we pray for his union today. Stretch your hand towards Chrissy. Lord, cover Chrissy's union. Amen. You see, the reason why I'm standing here tonight, guys, is because, of course, this is Chris's special night. And Chris does not like when people tell him no. Of course, he paid me tonight to do that. So that's why I'm here. Chris has a big heart, of course, and he also has a big appetite. Chris' favorite meal is seafood. Whatever he sees, he eats. Okay, that's not the truth. Let's be honest. Chris is a very picky eater. Chris does not eat from anybody. So I'm trying to figure out what happened, Chris. Chris' dream is to one day have a six-pack and wear a G-string on Love Beach. At this point, guys, the G-string is still possible. I saw a big red one at Sandy's the other day. You came to mind when I saw it. But guys, the truth is, the six-pack has packed up and left for Andres. You see, there's a song said, I was minding my own business when the Lord spoke to me. He gave me a message because he saw that you was in misery. That one time you tried working out with JD. He told me to tell you he has not forgotten you. He said, just hold on, be strong, keep the faith, and in the nick of time, the six-pack you desire will be mine. Chris, happy birthday.
Woo! That was our first roast, Junior Scott. All right, coming now with our second roast. Our second roast is none other than Miss Desiree Taylor. And she done tell me, she got this fella cook. So this goose is cooked.
Let's go, Des. Let's go, Des.
I already see the night is starting off with liars. Good night, everybody. I want to say, first of all, happy birthday to Chris. He is my friend, aka the goat. And unlike Jonya, I'm not a really, really good roaster. But I got some dirt on Chris that I think, you know, I could share. But, so for those persons who don't know, me and Chris have been having children for the last 20 years together. So those persons who say Chris, Junior told a lie, he said Chris doesn't have, you know, he said Chris have four children. He has actually more than four children. We have about a lot of children together, all right? Yeah, so you know, if y'all don't record this now, because I know y'all like sent it to BPL and all them things, as I tired of being up on them stage. But let me tell you about Chris. Chris is the person that I call when I have little situations in my classroom. And one day I had this little boy in my classroom, he would not behave. And so I started calling everybody I know from the police force. Nobody answering their phone. So I said, you know what? Which friend I know could tell a good lie? A real convincing lie. And Chris came to mind. So I dialed Chris' number, right? And I dialed his number. He answered it right away. And I said, without any prompting, I say, ASP, Hyla. He said, this is he. I had him on speaker. So I said, you know, I have this student right here in my class. And I mean, this boy wouldn't behave. And I just went to town with it. Chris say, well, let me tell you something. I just came from the mall. You know what I was doing in the mall? I just came and to identify a little boy that's 12 years old, who got his head blown right off. So everybody in the class was like, oh. And I was like, Chris, I didn't want you to go all the way in, you know? So he said, yeah. And you know, when I get there, not only his head was blown off, his hands was blown off. That time I had a retired teacher, we call him a supply teacher in my class. She said, Jesus. So I'm like, how do I stop this? But he just won it. He said, yeah, and then you know, whilst we was to the mall, some other guys came around the corner and they start shooting up. I said, Lord Jesus. So the children, so the boy, he start crying. He said, oh Lord, he said, you know what can happen? I'm gonna come and pick you up and catch to the mall tomorrow. So you can see this boy. And so the supply teacher said, Lord Jesus Taylor, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. I say, ASP Hilo, ASP Hilo, thank you very much. But he wanted to go further. He wanted to go further with that story. So he kept on going in, kept on going in. So when the story was over, I tried to pull my class together. I said, Jesus, how am I going to pull this class back together? The whole week, the children was traumatized. And then something said to me, this is how Chris has traumatized me. Y'all, I just be traumatized when I have to deal with this man. Traumatized. So, you know, the story didn't end. The story really didn't end there. I guys, it's a true story. The story didn't end there. So now the supply teacher, her name is Deborah Markey. She called me. She said, Taylor, that night when I get home, she said, Taylor, I trouble. Let's get together and pray for that man. She said, let's get together and pray for the man. I didn't know how to tell the woman it wasn't true. So I said, Debbie, I said, you know, yeah, we got to pray. She said, let's pray together. And she prayed on the phone for 30 minutes for a person who don't exist. And so I want to say, Chris, thank you for traumatizing my life. He just bring help, but he also just bring trauma. And so guess what? I believe that if he traumatizing me, I must share the traumatization. And that's right? Yeah. All right. So that's my first story. Now the next, now I know this is a roast, but I don't do a good roasting in public. Because I have to say the things, but I have to say the Chris. I can't say it in public because I in the church, y'all. Y'all know what I'm saying? Oh, y'all don't go to church, eh? Okay. All right. Well, I in the church, so... Some of the things I have to say to him, I have to say, and y'all, let me tell you something, Chris Petty, y'all ain't know that name. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Jackie, I don't want to go all the way in. Y'all, he petty bad. Y'all know he petty bad, right? All right, well, let me tell you one petty story. So, oh, Jesus, Lord, look how you get myself in front. Y'all, he just waiting for tomorrow. He just waiting for tomorrow, but I always ready. So let me tell you, he petty bad. So anyhow, he just helped me with these children, y'all. And not only petty, he good, you know. He good, and so you gotta kind of like take the pettiness with the good. But child, I can't take that pettiness all the time. So anyhow, I got these scholarships that we naming, right? For these children with going to school. And so we started naming them. Now he don't know we naming something after him. It just seemed the scholarship. So what he can do? Because I tell him we've been having children a long time. Ah, I see a name and scholarship after people. One better be named after me. So y'all, I block him and then I unblock him quickly because if he didn't see I didn't block him, he wasn't going to help me with the children no more, you know? So I block him and then unblock him, right? So listen now, so wait, we named this banquet after him. Y'all, I don't dress up often. But I go on and I order this new dress. Guys, the dress was hot. It was hot. I ordered this new dress for this man. Y'all think he show up? When he show up, 1 hour later, I was so wet. I put on my slippers. I put on my jeans. And when he show up, I just continue serving. Why? Because I know he in love with me, but he's scared to tell you all. Jackie, you know, he's scared to tell you all. He invited me to his house. He sent me the location. And I show up to the house, y'all. I was scared to go inside. Look at this woman. She got start laughing like, child, tell me some more. I was scared to go inside. But anyhow, I went inside. Sat down, we talked. As soon as I got outside, because he wanted everybody to know real woman be in this house, you know? As soon as I left the house, guess what? In the chat. Y'all, guess who be into my house? Yeah, y'all would. I was like, look, Jackie, you know it's true, eh? Jackie, you can testify, you know. I say, what the? You know, but Chris is my friend, y'all, and I thought it important for me to come tonight to let him know that he's important to me. I want to tell you, not only he's petty, he's a nag. Y'all know he's a nag, right? Let me tell you all how I know he's a nag. So I had this event again with some children, and the place that we were supposed to stay, they decide that, you know, they needed to give it to somebody who had more money. So here I am with 60 children and no place for these children to stay, no place for 60 children to sleep. So of course I call him, and guess what? Not only he's a nag, he ain't gonna never let you know he care like he care. You know, he always gotta play like he tough, like, you know, and calling me for, I say anyway, I hang the phone up, I say anyway, I don't wait for the call. So he called me back, he said, I call a certain person. Let me see if the MP here, where my glasses is. Jackie is my eye. So he called the MP and he couldn't get him. Call him and he couldn't get him. I kid y'all not. When Chris showed me the screenshot before the MP calling back, if Chris ain't called that man about 500 times, all I see is miss calls. I say, this man really in love with me. You know, you only do things for people when you're in love with them, right? And so I want to say tonight, happy birthday to Chris. I appreciate him, and I came tonight just to show my face to let him know he is indeed appreciated and loved.
I tell you, she's the queen of comedy. She hard like that. Now, I got one other little game here. Some papers were pulled around to you. And I got some prizes to give out as well. Why this one got another zero in it? First of all, say Martin, 100 tickets? We can deal with him. Zero!
Seven!
Five! Oh! This is getting hot. One!
Woo! That's us!
That's us? You better check your ticket right.
051.
Bring it on! Bring it on! 051! State your name, your address, your date of birth.
I want everything.
Shauna Lee Lewis.
Shauna Lee Lewis. From where?
Nassau, Bahamas.
From Nassau, Bahamas. Oh, glory. Let's give it up for Shauna Lee Lewis from Nassau, Bahamas. The $100 gift certificate. All right, coming up now, to bring up the rear. He said we saved the best for last. Coming all the way. All the way. From that far off land. Where you from? Freeport, Abaco, Angus, Inagua. But that's my home, girl. All the way from Congo Town, Fox Hill. We bring it up for Karen Newton.
Good night, everyone.
Right, good.
No, Mom. I can't do that.
Okay,
so first and foremost, there was a mistake, and I wasn't aware that I was coming for this. Okay? I didn't see no flyer till the day. Because, and I was coming to party, but they tell me I was coming to roast an old Wild Andrus hog. So I thought, sorry. Okay, sorry about that. So forgive me because I'm a little bit ill-prepared, right? I ain't saying Rev is a hog, I said in size. Put the fork down, what's wrong with you, bro? See, threatening me, right? Yeah, I ain't saying he like big like a hog. I just saying he get waves like a hog. No, but believe me. I can't talk about Rev weight because I fat, number one. Number two, he really does not have as big an appetite as a lot of people think, right? If you look in Rev fridge right now, you get leftovers in there from everything he ate this week. Actually, if he used to eat vegetables, I would have said he's eat like a rabbit. But he don't eat like a rabbit, and there's something else that rabbits get a lot of that he ain't had none of for years. Right? Yeah. No. I'm not trying to be disrespectful. Okay? As y'all know, I call him Rev because I have that respect for his office, right? And his anointing. Okay? But if I knew this was the kind of roast I was asked to do, I would have declined, Rev, because, you know, I take it hard to diss you and your miserable self. Right? No, it's for real. No, but seriously, stop laughing. Reason number one, Rev and me ain't no company. He graduated in 1984 with that crew of people over there and my mom. Yeah. Right? And reason number two is because this man don't let nothing go. I know this is a setup. That's why I done block you off Facebook and everything. Right? Petty bad. So I'm fully prepared for the backlash. I got thick skin. So Rev, you could go to town on me. I don't mind. I won't hold it against you. Because you know him for being little dude. You know? So, no, seriously, like, I didn't, when people used to say something little off, right? I used to disagree because I was in his JP course and he's the smartest person that I know. Very intelligent, very well learned, very smart man. And then my mommy called me this week and I find out that we related to you closely. How close? I'm glad you asked. Rev, my great grandfather, and you had to call uncle or something like that, some sort of thing my mommy was telling me. And so I was like, oh, so he's smart. Except I find out that my great grandfather and my great grandmother had 5 beautiful children together, one of whom was my grandfather. And they shared a long, happy life together. But then mommy tell me they was brother and sister.
Yeah, mother said dread.
So, yeah, y'all do the math. It skipped me though. Truly. On a serious note, there's nothing I could say negatively about. I ain't even looking over there no more.
Cool.
No, seriously though. No, stop laughing. Y'all making it worse. There's nothing I could say negatively about Rev. He's been a really good friend to me. I won't say everything, but I really do appreciate you. On another serious note though, you have a lot of love to give. You know what I realized he had a lot of love to give? When he got that dog, Shekinah. I have never seen anyone love a Shih Tzu like that in my life. Now, I don't know how much of y'all is pet people. I can't do it. I can't deal with no smelly creature around me, stooling everywhere, always pumping, gotta eat every second. It's disgusting. I don't know if she kinda does it. Well, stop. Run to me. Okay. No. Okay, no, seriously though. No, this is the last thing I have to say. On a serious note. Seriously? Eunice. Okay, no, for real. To be serious. Serious. I admire your boldness. You are the boldest person that I know. You don't care what people think about what you have to say, how you feel, and I admire that. Put the fork down, please. One thing we can all agree on, this man is a straight shooter. He shoots straight with everything, except for when he pees. Because when you're young, it's straightly, and when you're old, it's a little shaky. But on a team, well. Well, I just want you to know that I love you. Okay, that's the last thing that I have to say. Seriously. On a serious note, Rev, I love you. You know, I want to thank you for thinking of me to be one of your roasters, because I know it takes a lot to sit and let people just roast you. You have to be really secure within yourself, you know? So, before I go, I just want to say thank you for the opportunity and thank you for leaving your feelings at home. on the dresser right next to your hairline. Good night, everybody.
Cool.
Drop the mic! Drop the mic! Oh my God! This is it! Oh my! I tell you, this hot. Well, Chris, all you gotta say is, you do it.
Where you going? Or should I ask where you're going?
Giveaway. Alright, Pope, you picking this one. Oh Lord, I'm yeah. 0 8 2 Check it, just make sure. 0 8 2
Lord.
She's winning every team tonight. I'm with you. Come, Mr. Photographer.
the mic. None other than Miss Hope Shellyann.
Good evening. Oh, y'all sound stale. Good evening. All right, all right. Well, I am up here this evening. I like to walk around. I don't like to be in one place. I need my little fan because, you know, a little over 50. So, you know, that's someone that's been even in the night. Amen? Y'all don't act like y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Because everybody in the front here hot. Amen? Okay. I am going to say a few things about my friend Christopher. Now, we all know Christopher is a man who speaks his mind. Whether you ask him to or you don't ask him to, he is definitely going to speak his mind. But even in speaking his mind, he's always truthful. Amen? Amen? If your outfit look bad, he can say, "Hope you look bad." But you got to take it for what it's worth because he's being truthful. One thing I've learned about this man, Christopher will give you what he don't have. Now, if you know anything about him, as hard as his mouth is, as much as he will get on Facebook and talk about everybody from top to bottom, and then when he talk about the people, he want tag you in the post to make sure you see the post, like you say what he's saying. Amen? But Christopher will give you. I'm telling you, he will give you what he don't have. And I think a lot of times, because of the bigness of his heart, his willingness to give, it just irritates him just a little bit when we don't reciprocate, when we call ourselves his friends, and we don't give back to him the way that he gives to us. When I was coming here, I said, "Chris, all these people gonna be roasting you. I can't stand up and say something nice." He said, "You gonna say something nice?" I say, "Yeah." And I'm gonna share with you my fondest memory of my friend. Okay. If Christopher is your friend, raise your hand. Yes. Yes. Each and every one of us have their fondest memory, right? Yes. I ain't gonna cry. In 2019, I had to have major surgery. And I was home for quite a while. Got laid off from one job, went ahead, did the surgery that I was putting off, and by the time as I recuperated months later, I started the next job in less than a week after that. God is good. My friend came to see me. He sat in the room with me and he talked for a minute. He don't ever stay long because he always in a hurry. Amen? You ever see him and he ain't in a hurry?
No.
As he was leaving, y'all know how Christopher go, right? Anytime he comes to see you, there's always an envelope. Yes. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? Yes. So he say, "Anyhow, this is for you. But don't open that till I go. Don't open that till I go." I obeyed him. I waited till he left, opened the envelope, and when I saw what was in that, can I tell you the dribbling, the hollering, the screaming, and the crying that was coming through the phone? Because Christopher is a friend. And he's one of those friends. If he's your friend, he's your friend. Now be fair warned. If he ain't your friend, he ain't your friend. He ain't your friend. If he ain't your friend, you ain't gonna wonder. Because you're gonna know. But Christopher, you have lived to see 57 years of life. To God be the glory. Great, 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 great things he's done. You're sitting in this big chair, and this chair is only a fraction of the bigness of your heart. We love you. We appreciate you. May God continue to guide you. May he continue to bridle your tongue when he needs to. But more than anything else, may he continue to allow you just to be you. Ladies and gentlemen, stand for 1 minute. Humor me. Let's clap for our friend. Come on. And wish him a happy birthday. Let me hear you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Shellyann.
It has been my pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Sean C. Thurston the First. And good night. I turn you over to the master DJ. Tell
him. If you hear Mary and get some penance. Listen, I am elated at the presence of everyone tonight. I'm not gonna call any names. I'm gonna keep it very well. I ain't called many names. I keep it general. Is Pastor Monkey still here?
No.
All right, I'll deal with him later. Me too. To my roasters, I'm simply going to say, tomorrow coming. I say no more. To all of you who came, I could go around the table and I can pick out and call names and be very specific about how important individuals are. So again, not to leave anyone out, I'm just going to be very general and know that I appreciate your presence. If there are a lot of things you don't know about me, because I'm a very open person, but if there is one thing about me you should know, is that togetherness and family means a whole lot to me. And so the fact that you took time to be here and celebrate this time with me warms my heart. And just know that to each of you, I am appreciative. When I win the lottery, I ain't telling you all that. But let me give you a clue. If I ever call you and say I need to borrow $1,000, if you don't have it, go borrow it. Because that'll be my way of knowing if I can use some of my winnings. Because you came through for me when you thought I needed it. But I am appreciative of all of you. I cannot allow this evening to go without celebrating my mother. My biggest supporter. All of you know that she's been going through some health challenges, and so I am grateful to God for her presence here with me tonight, and I pray that God gives her an even longer life. I think Pastor, Pastor Sylvia. Alright, so I'll put up the Baptist thing, I thought she's gone. But certainly to my sisters Tasha and Taddy, who are always in my corner, always supporting, know that I love you and I'm grateful for you. I want to single one person out particularly, and this is he's older than me, but I still call him a young man that I met when I went to Nashville, Tennessee in 1995. The Reverend Martin Espinosa. He is originally from Trinidad. He pastors in Nashville and thought it not robbery to come to Nassau this weekend to celebrate my birthday with me. I am grateful for your presence. To all of you, that song that I had Marcy play when we came out is indeed the testament of my life. He's been faithful. I didn't understand growing up when the old people used to say, He's been good to me better than I've been to myself. I now understand. And then the first time I heard a preacher say, God did not deal with me according to me. I now understand. Because if it were for me, and he was like us, I wouldn't be sitting here. But God. And many of you know the story of my life. But God. I close now because I'm ready to dance. I particularly asked the person who did the draping of this tent to drape the poles. I don't know which one I'm swinging on tonight, but I can be on one of them. And in case you're wondering, I wore my G-string tonight. Let me tell you this. I told her when I was in R&B in the guidance department, I told a group of my students, I said, listen, the day I weigh 1 pound under 300, I'm coming on campus in a G-string and I can do a spin in the middle of the courtyard. And one of the students said to me, say, Reverend Roberts, use that G-string. I say, yes. The next one said, well, I didn't know this, make them no size. I said, well, let me tell you what has happened. When I start putting them on, these big boxers. Time as I get them up, these BG. Now, there was a lesson in that. Roasters can't hurt you when you roast yourself. For them, one for them. But I am grateful. I am grateful. I've told this story over and over again, and I purposely say it every year. There was a lady, a church mother. To this day, I don't remember what I did. I used to be mischievous, y'all. I used to be mischievous. Obviously, I did something, and she was the choir director. Very well respected, very well honored in the church. Anyone from New Hope here? Brenda's still here? Oh, she's gone. She didn't know what I'm talking about. She was a choir director, senior choir director, very respected woman. And I could see her going up on the pulpit, and she turned around and she looked at me and she said, You will not live to see 20. I was around 15. I believed Huck, the church mother. I believed what she said so much till the first time I sat down and wrote out my funeral program was as I was approaching 20 because I was convinced that I would die. And if y'all know me, I like to have control, so I want to know what y'all are going to do when I leave, so I put it in right now. I don't want nobody talking over me who I don't want to talk. I can say who I want, and I've continued that tradition. But let me tell you the God I serve. Come on. I can't. No, I can't use that word. But yeah, I'm going to use it.
Oh, you roasted it.
It's your party.
That heifer died 2 weeks before I turned 20. God didn't let her live to see me turn 20. And guess what? I had to sing to a funeral. So when I sit here at 57, 37 years beyond what the devil thought. Ain't nothing but God. So as I look back over my life, I can see how his hand. All right, I was supposed to preach, and then I said I want to answer. I'm next to you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you to my brother Sean, who came from Freeport to host tonight. Thank you to all my friends in my class of 84 that's here. Thank you. Thank you, my aunt is here, my cousin is here, other family, my adopted. One of my adopted moms, Mom Thurston, is here. Listen, I am so grateful. The gentleman who keeps the smile on my mother's face, Mr. James Wells, he's here. COVID almost took him out, but he's still here. I'm just grateful, y'all. I'm grateful. Thank you to the young man who cooked the food. Is actually a former student of mine. He's from the Defense Force. He did a wonderful job. The daughter of the president of our class did the desserts. Thank you, Kelly. I'm grateful. And so that covers us. Thank you, Hope Shelly.
Okay, thank you, welcome.
Now call my name hard on the radio this week. Thank you to all of you. Let me stop right there. All of you know, everyone sitting here know that there is something special, something connected. Today is my baby birthday.
Today
is Shekinah's birthday. Y'all didn't get excited. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all need a dog to appreciate the love. You got God. That's all I can say, but that's my baby. Thank you, Justina, who did the comforters for us to start tonight. My sister Tadasi did the food kebabs. Thank you so much. I can stop right there. And certainly thank you all for paying. Now let me tell you something. This was a no $30 event. It's a no $30 event. But the reason I charge you and I have to come. Because you don't bring gifts. Come eat up all my damn food and go. Come bring it, Jackie. Lord Jesus, I think I do the wrong thing because this one, Lord, she ain't got much breaks. You going on this cruise with us? This my classmate, Jackie. Oh Jesus, thank you, Jackie. Thank you.
Thank you.
MC, you had some clothespins.
Uh-huh.
Bring that for me. I need you here.
Oh.
I about to do this. Amen? One thing I know for sure, women don't leave their house without money in their bag. This is what I need for all y'all who love Chris as much as I love Chris to do. Get up. Get a clothespin. Let's spend some money on my friend. Get up now. Let's go. You didn't know I was going to do this, eh? I know. Come. Open your bag. Whatever you have, bring it. And we don't give change. So if all you have is 50, then 50 it is. Get your clothespin. Spend some money. Come on. Let's go. Come on, class of 84. I know y'all buy AMK. Come this way. All these beautiful ladies here. I see this one that said, she got a dick so genius for $300 coming on this Bible here. I done see it. I speak it. Gentlemen, if you ain't got no money, ask your wife. Money in a bag. You can believe that. Get your clothes, print. Let's print some money on the birthday boy. Amen, Bob. Alright.
So bring your good times and your laughter too.
Come on up here. Come bounce it. You know I just be happy when you're coming up for the lecture. I they bring in US and on. So if you're traveling, you're straight. Bring it, 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 bring it. Get your clothespin from the gentleman right over there, from the MC.